Hello everyone, welcome to my new lecture series that is nothing but the blockchain technology which is designed based on the syllabus of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Technological University Lonare for final year computer engineering student. So the first unit from the syllabus is the introduction to the blockchain. So here we start with the blockchain definition, then overview of a blockchain, the public ledger, Bitcoin, smart contract, block in the blockchain, transaction, distributed consensus, public versus private blockchain, and so many are there. So in today's lecture we are going to discuss about the overview of a blockchain and the public ledger. So the simple definition for the blockchain is nothing but the chain of a block. So simply, as you are the computer science student, we know what actually the linked list. Okay, so based on the linked list, so let's suppose if in the linked list, if I just go for the linked list, so in the linked list I can have the data structure that's having the address of previous node. Okay, so that is what the two fields are for the address, and one field is for the data. So here the data is present actually, and then the field of a next node we can consider. Okay, so likewise, inside of a blockchain we can have the chain of a block, and they are connected again by means of addresses. How they are connected to each other, what kind of address is going to be used, that we will discuss later. So we'll see the definition first. So the definition for the blockchain is nothing but it is the decentralized computation and information sharing platform that enables a multiple authoritative domains who do not trust each other to cooperate, coordinate and collaborate in the rational decision making system. Now if you just consider whatever the key element or key keywords which are present inside of a definition, so if I just elaborate all these keywords, you are able to understand the definition of the blockchain. So the first and most important keyword is nothing but the decentralized computation and information sharing platform. Decentralized indicates what? There is no central authority to perform the task. Okay, so the task will be done on the basis of peer-to-peer protocol. Okay, so the decentralized computation and information sharing platform, which is responsible or that enables a multiple authoritative domains. Multiple authoritative domains means what? From, or we can say, the different node belonging to the either whatever the different countries or different organization, that's having the equal priority, or we can say that's having the equal value inside of a chain. But there is no trusted third party, okay, or the intermediary is not there who is responsible for validation of the transaction. So there is one more question: who is responsible for the validation of this transaction? Obviously the miners are there who are responsible for the validation of the transaction, or even though whatever the different nodes which are present, they are also able to do the validation of the transaction. And these all together, okay, are come together to cooperate, coordinate and collaborate in the rational decision making system. And on the basis of that, whatever the things which is available with me, on the basis of that I must have to make the decision whether the transaction has been successful or whether the transaction has not been executed. So like for example, if I just go for the decentralized network, so decentralized network will look like this. So here the central authority is there, here the central authority is there who is responsible for making all kind of a decision. But if I just go for the decentralized network, so I don't have any kind of a centralized authority who is actually doing all the transaction. Advanced version 2, this one is nothing but the distributed. In a distributed, what happens is the each node is connected directly to the neighboring node. Okay, so here likewise, a decentralized computation and information sharing platform. Decentralized means what? No central authority is there who is monitoring all the transaction or who is responsible for making the decision. That's have all the control. That's enable the multiple apps. As the central authority is not there, whatever the different nodes present inside of a network, are responsible for making the transaction as well as validating the transaction. Now, if you just consider an example of a current banking system. So, for example, whatever the current banking systems available inside of India or anywhere, so all they are based on what we can say, the central system. All they are based on the central system. One central server will be there who is responsible for making the transaction. Okay, who are making? So they are using the centralized system. So for example, here the allies want to transfer $10 to the Bob. So the allies will do the logging inside of a banking website or banking application, and he generates the transaction to transfer the $10 from Alice's account to the Bob account. Now this transaction is sent to the server, or simply we can say the bank, and here the bank is responsible for making the decision whether the amount is to be debited from Alice's accounts and credited into the Bob's account. So all the transactions are going through these trusted third parties, but that is not case if I just go for the decentralization system. That is what the peer-to-peer transaction. So here you are going to use what? Peer-to-peer transaction. Now here Alice is responsible for generating the transaction. Let's say Alice is generating the transaction. Alice pays $10 to the Bob, and Bob gets the $10. Now the question is that in this particular network, who is going to validate the transaction? Who is going to validate the transaction? And this validation will be done by using the different nodes which are available inside of a network. But here you are not using the trusted third party. Here you are not using the trusted third party. So no control is given to the single party or a single node to perform all the transactions inside of a network. Okay. So here in the definition again, a decentralized computation and information sharing platform. Either you are information sharing platform indicates either you are just performing the transaction or you are sharing some kind of a document in the particular network that enables the multiple authoritative domains, okay, or the nodes from the different organization or a single node. They were having what the same value, who do not trust each other, okay, who do not trust each other. Even though they don't trust each other, they are responsible for cooperate, coordinate and collaborate in the rational decision making system. So for example, if Alice is sending few amount of her balance to the Bob, okay, now here the decision is that decision that you have to make or the node has to make is nothing but what amount, okay, whether this transaction is the valid transaction or not. Once the transaction is valid, so the amount is debited from the Alice account and credited inside of a Bob's account. Okay, so that is what the definition of the blockchain. In a simpler way, the blockchain can be also defined as the decentralized database with a strong consistency support. Again, as it is a decentralized database means what? Whatever the nodes which are present inside of a network, so that nodes have the copies of all the transactions that has been executed in the network. Now, let's suppose this is nothing but the network, or we can say the decentralized network, okay, available to you. Again, I don't do it as in center. So this is what is simply a decentralized network available with me. So whatever the nodes, node 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 nodes are there, they were having the copies of all the transactions available with them. That is what the ledger. Ledger is nothing but the document which consists of all the previous transactions that are executed inside of this network. So all the copies are available with each and every node which is present inside of a distributed network. So same copy will be available, same copy will be available, same copy will be available. Now, so as it is a decentralized database system, so it does not depend on the center system. ये पर्टिकुलर सेंटर सिस्टम पे डिपेंड रहने की कुछ भी ज़रूरत नहीं. ईच एंड एवरी नोड कैन हैव द सेम वैल्यू ओवर देयर और दे कैन परफॉर्म द सेम ऑपरेशन इनसाइड ऑफ ए नेटवर्क. ओके, सो द डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड डेटाबेस विद द स्ट्रॉन्ग कंसिस्टेंसी सपोर्ट. अगेन वन मोर डेफिनेशन फॉर द ब्लॉकचेन हैज बीन गिवन बाय द लेंटीसी एज वेल एज द लखानी. दिस सेज दैट ब्लॉकचेन इज एन ओपन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड लेजर दैट कैन रिकॉर्ड द ट्रांजेक्शन बिटवीन द two parties efficiently and in verifiable and permanent way. So the blockchain is an open indicates what anyone can join that network. No identification will be required to join the particular network. Only the thing is that you have to create the wallet. Okay, distributed ledger, we have seen the concept of a distributed ledger. Actually, distributed ledger, all the records or all the previous transactions are available with all the nodes in which are present inside of a network. So that can have the records of a transaction between the two parties effectively. Effectively means what? Whatever the validated transactions are present, and in the verifiable and permanent way. All the transactions which are present in this particular ledgers are verified or validated transaction. And once the transactions are validated, you have to write down the result and make that transaction done successfully, and that is what the permanent way. So you must have to write down to all the ledgers. Okay, so that indicates the consistency of your database. So again, if you have any kind of a queries in the definition, so you can just write down inside of a comment. So I will give you the answer to that queries. But meanwhile, only just consider blockchain as an decentralized computation and information sharing platform, which is responsible for performing the different transaction without using of a trusted third party, without using the trusted third parties. Okay, now see, as we are not using a trusted third parties, so in the decentralized network, the execution of a transaction is faster as compared to the centralized system. Okay, now see, consider an example where I'm just transmitting where I'm just doing the stock trading. Okay, so here the different users are there, like Charlie is there, Alice is there, company A, company B, Bob. These are the individual. Charlie, Alice, Bob's are nothing but the individual user. Okay, and this one is nothing but the organization. Now if I just use the centralized authority, in the centralized authority the company A can have the different rights, while as the individual user can have the different rights. But that is not the case when we deals with the blockchain or distributed kind of a system, because this each and every node, even though it is the individual node and it is the organization, will be treated equally. Okay, will be treated equally. Now if you consider that whatever the today's stock trading is available with us, so what happens over there? So let's suppose Alice want to buy some stock, so she can easily buy the stock. Only the thing is that Alice has to transfer the money from her account to the trading house or clearing house. Okay, so it is very easy to buy the share, but it is very time consuming to sell the share, because now consider Alice is again want to sell the share to the Bob. Okay, so share to the Bob. Once the share has been sold to the Bob, but it requires 2 to 3 days to deposit the money into the Alice account, because the deposition and the transaction verification and validation will be done by the clearing house, will be done by the clearing house. Okay, and they require the time, because they have to check all the previous data. On the basis of that, they have to check whether that Alice having the share with her or not. When again that share are going to be transmitted from Alice account to the Bob's trading account, and the money which has been initiated or fund transfer that has been initiated by the Bob must be added into the Alice account. All these things will be done by the clearing house, and they require the large amount of a time. But this can be solved by using the concept of a distributed network, or we can say the peer-to-peer trading, by using the concept of a blockchain. So here no intermediate system is there. That is what the clearing houses which is present in this diagram is not present over here, and each and every node have the record of previous transaction. Okay, and all they have the same copies. For example, Alice, whatever the transaction are present in the ledger of Alice, all the transactions are present in the ledger of a Charlie, then company A, then Bob, as well as the company B. Okay, so this is what the advantages of the peer-to-peer system. Now here what happens, so if Alice want to buy the share of any company, so direct communication will be there from the Alice to the company A, and if she want to sell share, again she can sell share directly to the Bob, and here Bob is responsible for initiating the fund transfer from Bob account to the Alice account. Okay, and all these things will be done on the basis of the previous history available in the ledger itself. No trusted party will be there. So now, as the trusted third party is not there, who is going to monitor the transaction, or who is going to validate the transaction? Now let's suppose in a previously sometimes the company A share, so let's suppose S1, S2, S3 has been purchased. Okay, as it is purchased, it is recorded at a transaction for purchase of share 1. Okay, then transaction 2, transaction of purchase of share 2. So iska matlab all these transactions are present in the Charlie's account, company A account, company B account, as well as the Bob account. Okay, so Bob can verify, on the basis of that, Bob can verify as Alice having the share 1 as well as the share 2. Okay, ye check karega. So once it has been checked, okay, so iska matlab the Bob is now able to receive the share 1 as well as share 2 from the Alice. Once it has been received, the Bob has to initiate the fund transfer. Okay, initiate the fund transfer. So the Alice is again generating the transaction that the share 1 is now transferred from Alice to Bob. Okay, share 2 is now going to transfer from Alice to Bob, and this transaction is initiated and broadcasted in the network, and the node which are present inside of network, either the Charlie or the company A, is going to verify whether this transaction is the accurate one or not. Once the transactions are going to be accepted or validated, then Bob initiate the fund transfer, and again in the same way that transaction is also going to be verified inside of a network. So that is what the beauty of a decentralized network. So it is not actually the time consuming one. So within an hour we can say the settlement of a payment will be done if you just go, or if you just use peer to peer trading. That is what the blockchain network as compared to the stock settlement through the clearing houses. Clearing houses are nothing but the intermediary system, or we can say the companies. Okay. Then we'll see the difference between the centralized versus decentralized architecture. So in the centralized architecture, if you just see the diagram, this central node is responsible for doing all kind of things, or they are responsible for monitoring the transaction inside of a network, or they are responsible for doing the communication from node to node. Okay, but if I go for the decentralized or the distributed architecture, no central authority is present. Let's suppose likewise this link is also there. Okay, so that will avoid the confusion. Okay, this is also the link which is present inside of a network. Okay, so let's suppose here the node 1 is trying to communicate with the node 2, or node 1 is trying to send some amount of a information to the node 2. So this information goes through this central authority. So the central authority can monitor all these transactions, or the central authority is responsible for moving the data from N1 to the N2. But in case of the decentralized networks, no central authority is responsible. Let's suppose this is the N1 and this is the N2. So data can be passed like this. Many more intermediary systems are present, and then it will reach to the end. Okay. So 1, 2, 3 intermediate systems are there, and lastly it will reaches to the destination. Okay. So if you just go for the difference of a decentralized and distributed, in the distributed architecture every node is connected or directly connected with the neighboring node. So cost of implementation is high for the distributed comparatively to the decentralized. Okay, and even the distributed networks are more complex as compared to the decentralized, but we don't have the proper difference between the decentralized as well as the distributed network. Only the difference between the centralized and decentralized networks are there. In the centralized system, the central server is responsible for executing the different thing, while as in the decentralized, the nodes are responsible for execution of the different thing. So this table shows the difference between the centralized and the decentralized cryptocurrency exchange actually. So here the control is there. So for example, for the centralized system, the control is given to the central server like this one. Okay, this central system is responsible for doing all the things inside of a network. And if you just go for the decentralized cryptocurrency exchange, no central server is there which is responsible for executing all the transactions, but the transactions are done based on the peer-to-peer decentralized protocol. In order to use the centralized system, it is very easy because the user don't have to understand the network topology, only they have to initiate the transaction. But if you go for the decentralized network, so it is not actually the user friendly because too much technical things are present. You have to work on the terminal in order to utilize the decentralized architecture. Okay. Then fees, higher transaction fees comparative to the higher transaction fees are there. Now just consider the example. अभी जो जनरल बैंकिंग सिस्टम यूज़ करते हो तो उसके लिए आप क्वार्टरली पे करते हो. यू आर जस्ट पेइंग क्वार्टरली फॉर द बैंकिंग सिस्टम. बट इफ़ आई जस्ट गो फॉर द ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ रुपीज, ओके, दिस इज द साइन फॉर रुपीज, राइट, रुपीज, एंड दिस रुपीज आर गोइंग टू बी ट्रांसमिटेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ ए डॉलर. ओके, दिस रिक्वायर्स a large amount of a transaction fee. Okay, if I just go for the centralized communication, okay, or centralized system. But if I just go for the rupees to dollar transfer and I'm just using the blockchain kind of a network, or if I'm just using the decentralized architecture, so it's having a very low cost, and that is equal to zero transaction fee. Identity of a user in the centralized cryptocurrency exchange, each and every user is known to the central authority. Each and every user is known to the central authority because central authority is going to monitor all kind of a operation performed inside of a centralized network. While as the identity of a user is anonymous in the distributed or the decentralized network. Okay, so anyone want to join the decentralized or distributed network, they can join at any time. No identity will be used while granting the permission. For example, no one will be asking you for the Aadhaar card, or no one will going to ask you for the PAN card to join the network. Okay, the centralized systems are slower comparative to the decentralized system, and they are having the risk of server downtime. Once this intermediate system down, okay, so a whole network collapse. But that is not case when you go for the decentralized or the distributed network. And accountability, user, whatever the user, they are responsible for performing the transactions are potentially held legally accountable if any kind of issue occurs. here accountability is not as apparent as a code could be considered as a law, and this code, so here we have to write down the program, and on the basis of that program we have to do the execution, and this kind of a code is known as a smart contract. Okay, again we'll discuss what actually the smart contract is there in detail later on. Smart contract, on the basis of the smart contract you have to execute the transaction accordingly. Okay, so this is all about the difference between the centralized versus the decentralized architecture. Now you can just understand again the definition of the blockchain. It is the blockchain is a decentralized database, right? So here again, if you just consider an example, what is there before the blockchain, what is there after the blockchain? What is there before the blockchain? Now before the blockchain we are having the central authority which is responsible for executing all the things inside of a network. So now this particular person want to send the data to this person, so this can be done by using the intermediate. Okay, and this intermediates can have only the ledger of all the node. Okay, of all the node. Likewise, so for example, consider the current banking system. You can have your passbook that's having the entry of yours only, right? Not the entry of other people. But this particular central authority can have the entry of all these people, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever the people they are, or whatever the nodes they are present inside of a network. Now just consider that if this particular node crash due to some network problem, so no availability of a ledger. Once the node has been crashed, you don't have the ledger available with the central system. So what happens? You don't have the history of a transaction which is done by the different user present inside of a network. Okay, so when the blockchain is not there, we have to use what? Centralized ledger with the centralized verification and computation. All the operation or all the validation will be done by the central authority. But once the blockchain is available with you, you are using the distributed ledger over here. Distributed ledger with decentralized verification and as well as the computation. So we are having the distributed ledger, and this ledger having what we can say all the transaction that has been done inside of a network. Okay, now consider that one of the node get fails due to some network problem or due to the network failure, even though the network can have all the transaction available with them. Once the new node has been inserted inside of a network, then they can have the copy of the transaction, okay, or nearby transaction, that again we'll discuss later on. Okay, so we'll stop here, and in the next lecture we'll basically go for the history where actually your blockchain has been implemented or used, so thank you everyone. If you are having any queries, put your question into the comment. I will just give you the answer. Okay, thank you.